The following program is being brought to you on the Voice America Empowerment Channel. For more information about our network and to check out additional show hosts and topics of interest, please visit voiceamericaempowerment.com. The Voice America Talk Radio Network is the worldwide leader in live internet talk radio. Visit voiceamerica.com. The views and ideas expressed on the following program are strictly those of the host or guests and do not necessarily reflect the views and ideas held by the Voice America Talk Radio Network, its staff, and management.
Welcome to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives with Rebecca Hall Greider. In our program each week, we provide the tools, ideas, and encouragement to help you move ahead on your journey, becoming a more powerful and impactful woman in your own life. Now here's your host, Rebecca Hall Greider.
Welcome to the show, everyone. I hope that you've had a beautiful week. And as we're getting further and further into the holiday season, I find we do a lot of reflecting. We spend time looking at this past year, looking forward to seeing friends and family, and then really looking towards 2015 and what is it that we're wanting to step more deeply into? What are we wanting to bring into our life and really call forth in 2015? So I thought it was a perfect time for us to lean in, come together, and focus on leadership. How can we step more strongly into a leadership position in our own lives, really living our lives on purpose and with purpose? So today I've brought two experts to support us in our journey. I have Garth Roberts. Garth, I welcome you to the show.
Thank you very much.
And Garth is a leadership expert, and he is a certified speaker professional and a thought leader and does a lot of speaking and teaching and workshops around leadership. So we're excited to kind of dig in and have a deeper conversation with you today, Garth.
Thank you. I'm looking forward to it.
Great. And then Grace is an astrologer and a numerologist, and she's been practicing for 25 years now, right? Is that right, Grace?
Almost 25, yeah.
Almost 25 years. Yeah, I'm not trying to make it longer, but thank you. Glad to have you with us. And I thought it would be really a great opportunity for us to look at leadership from a lot of different perspectives to give you insight and support on your journey, because I think there's misunderstandings about leadership and how we can stand more firmly in that, in our relationship with ourselves and others and our life. And so that's what I hope we really gain in our conversations together. So Garth and Grace, I'm very excited to have you joining us.
Great to be here, Rebecca. Thanks.
Mm-hmm. And then I always like to have us start the show by reflecting on a couple things and really taking a moment to pause and listen. We can get so caught up in the hustle and bustle of life and in the season that we don't always take time to pause, to listen and reflect. And yet I find when we carve out time in our life to do that, it gives us a different perspective, an ability to tap into more of our wisdom and resources to purposely move forward towards those things we want more of in our life and away from the things we want less of in our life. And one of the things that I've been getting a lot of questions around lately is money. Some of you know that I come from a financial background, so I have over 14 years of experience in advising clients and individuals and companies, really empowering them to make that money connection so that it can serve them and help them move forward. And so I frequently get a lot of questions around money, particularly this time of year. And so I just wanted to share one of the top comments I've been getting lately and my thoughts about that, because it may be something you're struggling with or somebody you know is struggling with. What I find is there's an uncomfortableness with money, that we don't quite know what to do with it or where to start. And the question I'll get frequently is, Rebecca, I don't quite like or understand, or I'm not quite comfortable with where I am with money right now. And so how can I make that different as I'm stepping into 2015? How can I have more in my life or be more connected or really have a more comfortable position or relationship when it comes to money? Where do I start? And here's the answer. You pause and you reflect on what is really important about money to you. What is important? What isn't important? And why? And that what is important, whether it is money or not, you want to keep exploring, asking if it's freedom. What about freedom? How do I define freedom? If it's having less pressure, less stress, what does that mean? How would it look? How does it feel? Really taking it further and further, exploring this question till you get to a point of feeling that this is what's important to me, or this is what I want in my life because it makes me feel this way. Feel good, feel happy, feel valuable. That's where you want to take that question. And once you discover that, what's important to you, where you're wanting to go, then you pause and you look at where you are now. Are there certain feelings, the emotions that come up around money? Are you avoiding it? Are you bringing it closer? Are you having more month than you have money? Really leaning in and kind of looking at, without judgment, just with curiosity, of exactly where you're at in your relationship with money. And then you have the picture of kind of where you want to go. And that's where you can start bridging the gap to bring it closer. And one of the common things I'll find is people are uncomfortable around money. They don't want to deal with it. They don't want to talk about it. It's stressful, pressure, all that kind of stuff. And I always pause and want you to think about what you're talking about in your relationship there. Because as long as it keeps being uncomfortable, it keeps being something you don't want to talk about, you're becoming disempowered in your relationship with money. And I really want to encourage you to stand in a powerful, empowered position, a leadership position in your relationship with money and with your life, really looking at where you want to go. How can we have it funnel together to lead to where you're trying to take things? And I'm using the example of money. But if you think about this, if we were looking at developing a friendship or a relationship, and you kept saying things like, I'm not sure if I trust that, Rebecca. I don't know. I know she laughs a lot. I'm not sure I'm into that. She has that radio show. I don't know how I feel about that. I'm not quite sure what to do with her. I'm not sure that I want to get too close. That would interfere with our relationship, and it wouldn't build trust. It wouldn't build a connection. And that's what can happen if we talk about money like that. You're creating a separation versus bridging a gap or bridging a connection. And so I encourage you with areas like money that you look at how to create a bridge and really look at how you're talking about that area. If it's bringing up an area of discomfort, how you're talking about that. And really look at that. So you want to look at where you're going, where you're at, and then how can you start leaning towards, stepping closer to where you're wanting to go with that. So with that, what I would love for us to do is to pause. Those of you who are driving, please be safe. Keep your eyes open. Keep both hands on the wheel. But for everyone else, if you could actually sit in a chair, put both feet on the floor, feel the back of the chair supporting you. Take a deep breath, kind of opening up your shoulders, feeling them supported by the back of the chair. Take a deep breath in, close your eyes. And just for a moment, think about leadership. Think about where you're wanting to go in 2015. It could be something in the area of relationships. It could be around money. It could be around things you're wanting to step forward or stretch into in 2015. Just kind of let some of those things percolate in you, run through your mind. And then put one hand on your heart, one hand on your head, the top of your head, and take a deep breath again. And ask yourself, self, what is it I need today, this week, to support me, to support you on your journey to getting closer to where you're wanting to be in 2015, to what you're wanting to step forward in, to where you're wanting to stand in a more empowered leadership position in your life. It's not an accident that you're on this call, that you're on this show, that you're listening, that you have your eyes closed right now and you're seeking. Honor that and listen. And see what word or phrase comes to your heart and mind. What is it you need, you're looking for, would serve you? One more deep breath. And Grace, I didn't know if you had something come to your heart or mind that you would like to share today.
What came up for me just now was focus.
Mm-hmm.
Which was an interesting thing to have come up. Simply because, you know, there are times during the day where I feel like I'm spinning a lot of plates.
Beautiful. Good. So focus. That's beautiful.
Yeah. One plate at a time.
Exactly. I like that. Focus. One plate at a time. Beautiful. And how about you, Garth? Did you have a word or phrase that came up?
Actually, I did. Focus works well for me. However, what came up for me was action.
Mm.
What I need to do in the rest of this month and 2015 is to put a lot of years of practice into action.
Beautiful. So then we can have focused action. I like that. Thank you. Thank you, Garth, for sharing. And I think for me, what came up is remembering to add extra moments of stillness and pausing. So I find, like what you were saying, Grace, is there are a lot of plates sometimes I'm juggling, and I try to throw even more in during the holiday season, and I love planning and looking ahead, and sometimes I can do that without taking the time to pause and reflect. So I really like that, and then taking the action. So thank you. I think those are both great shares and insights. And listeners, we're getting ready to go to our first commercial break, and this is what I'd invite you to do during the next couple minutes. Continue to listen to what it is, the word or the phrase that's placed on your heart, so that you can lean into that during our show in this coming week to really support you in moving forward in your life in a really powerful and effective way. We'll look forward to talking to you in just a moment.
It's your world. Motivate, change, succeed. VoiceAmericaEmpowerment.com.
You have the power within to achieve anything, be it wealth, balance in your life, getting over your fears and roadblocks, and creating a positive impact on the world. Let Darby Mack show you how on the Powerful, Passionate, Prosperous Woman Show. Darby will bring you the tools and tips that you need to make it all happen with engaging guests and topics that will help you make your dreams come true. The Powerful, Passionate, Prosperous Woman Show is heard live every Thursday at 9 a.m. Pacific Time, noon Eastern Time on Voice America Empowerment.
Rebecca Hall Greider's Speaker Talent Search is looking for people like you. With just 1 7-minute audition, you could open the doors to hundreds of speaking opportunities. This is a dynamic way to share your message, reach more people, and expand your impact. Apply now at yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent. Finalists get to audition live in front of community leaders looking to fill all kinds of speaking opportunities. Don't wait. Find out more. Visit yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent.
Build your better business. Achieve that goal. Make good on that resolution. The Voice America Empowerment Channel. It's your world. Motivate, change, succeed.
You're listening to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives with your host, Rebecca Hall Greider. If you have a question or comment for Rebecca or her guest, we'd love to hear from you. Please call into the program at 1-888-346-9141. That's 1-888-346-9141. You may also send an email to Rebecca at yourpurposedrivenpractice.com. Now back to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope you had the opportunity to be still and listen, to really see what's placed on your heart and mind, the message that will really help you move forward in a powerful way as we're stepping into 2015. And just before the commercial break, we were talking about taking action and focusing. So focusing one plate at a time, as Grace so beautifully said, and then really the things that we have learned and practiced, being able to take action and implement those things in our lives. With that, I'd like to do a more in-depth introduction of our first guest today, and this will be Garth Roberts. And I mentioned before that he's a thought leader, he's a leadership coach and trainer and workshop leader. He also has extensive experience in as a TV and film producer, director, actor, and educator. And he's also an award-winning writer. So he's bringing a lot of depth and information from a variety of industries in the wisdom that he's going to be sharing with us today. So Garth, I officially welcome you to the show.
Thank you very much. It's great to be here.
Glad to have you. And here's the question I love to start with. And especially I'm thinking with you, Garth, because you have such a wide and rich background in a lot of different modalities and in a lot of different industries. So why is leadership and the work that you're doing around leadership so important to you, that that's what you're bringing forward and sharing with your gifts and your talents?
I came to leadership partly through the broadcast industry, because as a writer-producer, even when you're new to the business, you end up leading teams very quickly.
Mm-hmm.
I think I was fortunate in that industry because there were so many very, very talented professionals who knew their jobs well. And when, whether it was in a television studio or on a film set or whatever, when someone says, you know, action or roll it or whatever, everybody went to their tasks with professionalism. So I kind of, I learned about leadership basically from a lot of peers, from a lot of mentors. And over the years, then I went into education and worked with a lot of students. And I discovered that I was learning practically as much from them as they were from me.
Mm.
But I noticed that you know, a lot of the students were leaders, and they weren't waiting around for someone else to tell them what to do. And I think that's why it fascinates me. And I, quite frankly, think we make it way too complex.
Thank you. And that's actually something I know before the show started, we talked about briefly how we can make leadership much more difficult and complex and complicated than it needs to be. So how do you type leader or define, I should say, leadership? Because I know if we look up leadership on Google or other social media, there's a lot of different definitions. There's a lot of different ways it can be looked at. And I'd love to know how you define it and take some of the complexity and complication out of it for us?
Well, leadership, you know, as you say, there's a few million. If you hit Google, there's a few million things that come up when you say leadership. First of all, everyone is a leader, and everyone has been leading most of their lives, because we all step up with our playmates on the schoolyard or even in kindergarten. We'll take the role and move the team along, if you will. So I don't know that I have a specific definition that pops out at me when it comes to leadership. To me, leadership is more of a collection of things, and basically what it amounts to from my standpoint is a good leader sets the path, which would be the planning.
Mm-hmm.
He communicates what's happening to whomever needs it. So, and then there's the follow-up to make sure that whatever the plan was, and even if it changed along the way, someone has to be responsible for following up and making sure that everything happened the way it was supposed to. A keynote I do is called Plan, Communicate, and Follow-Up, and to me it's that kind of three steps. So from my standpoint, leadership is really a lot to do with planning. One of the best bosses I ever worked for was a master at setting the path, if you will. And then she didn't quite frankly care if she was in front or if she was behind, as long as one of us were leading. And I think that was the key thing. You talked about finances. Well, we all have to lead in our own finances. And no one else is going to do it for us. And you have to, when you're communicating, you have to talk to the bank, the family, your friends, to your partners. And the first thing, of course, is to put that plan in place. I think another thing about leadership that many people think is that there's this one person. No, there are many people. I've been led, I've received good insight from some of the newest people on some of my teams. Age or experience does not necessarily make you a great leader. What makes you a great leader is always listening, always observing, and always be opening to be led as you lead.
Beautiful. Thank you for sharing that. I just want to underline a couple of things you shared, if that's okay, Garth. I just thought they were really powerful and profound. And you shared how everyone is a leader. And that listening and being willing to be led as well as lead are great qualities in leadership. And I was just reflecting on that a little bit, because I have found some of the leaders that have impacted me the most powerfully and helped me really shift or move forward or stand in leadership in a stronger way were people that were willing to lead and be led, that they were able to really walk both places in a really powerful way. And just like you were sharing about one of the leaders that really impacted you, how she was, in a sense, it sounded like leading a vision. And as long as we were going that way, she didn't have to be the one out in front showing this is the path. She could be in the walking behind others as long as you were moving together in that sort of a direction, moving the plan, in a sense, forward.
Right, and I think that's so critical. I think we make leadership too complex. And over the years, I've done various programs, and I've put together my own program called A Simpler System, Seven Keys to Inspired Leadership, because I do think it is a simpler system. I think it's just taking steps. And the first step is the S in simpler, is you have to know yourself. Discover how your unique style impacts others, whether it's customers, whether it's family, whether it's friends. And don't be afraid to stand up and look in the mirror and say, who am I? What's working? What's not working? One of the things I always encourage participants in seminars to do is for the next week or more, everything that comes across their desk, ask the question, very simple question, if I don't do this, will anybody notice? Because we all have all sorts of stuff that floats by us that actually could be left alone and not done. It's outlived its usefulness. which in the second part of the simpler is to the I is the inventory time, and that's part of it. Take an inventory. What's working? What's not working? From a business standpoint, the M is marketplace. Identify your own market trends, etc. And I don't care if you're in a big company, little company, or if you're a solo entrepreneur at home. What's happening where you play? And I use play rather than work.
Because I like
that. We need to think about it as play occasionally. You know, what's happening out there? I know one point I got very absorbed in where I was working, and I forgot what was happening in my industry.
Yep, and that can happen. We can forget to look up and look around. And I wanted to see, I know you've put together an amazing free gift, and I wanted to give you a moment to share in your words a little bit about what this gift is and what you're making available to the listeners today.
Well, basically, it's an ebook that I mm-hmm. have initially, 7 Key Strategies to Inspired Leadership, and it's talking about the strategies that the 7 keys that I feel are really important. And I've my interpretation of what those keys are, and as I said, it starts with mm-hmm. self and goes to inventory.
Yep.
And basically, I would like people to download it, to sit back and read it and reread it and tear it apart and agree or disagree. That doesn't really matter. But to think about what are they going to do with their own leadership of their life, of their business, of their relationships in 2015. And
yes.
And I don't, you know, go to a coffee shop, print it off, watch it on your iPad, whatever you do. But feel free to challenge yourself.
Thank you. And I think this is a perfect time of year to do that. Really take a moment and look at what you're stepping into. Be really deliberate about it. I love the idea of having an ebook that they can go through and really explore where they stand in these concepts and these keys that you're sharing about leadership. Where do they start and stop in that? And what action are they going to take based on that information? So I think that's really, really valuable. And listeners, I really encourage you to lean into this valuable gift that Garth is making available to you. But here's the catch. You have to stay on the show, listening to the end of the show, and I will let you know how to access this valuable gift as well as the valuable gift that Grace is going to be sharing with you and making available as well. And as we're getting ready to go into our next commercial break, I want you to lean into the word or phrase that came to your heart and mind before about what it is around leadership and around your life that you purposely and consciously, one plate at a time, want to focus on bringing forward and then adding that critical step that you were sharing about, Garth, about really taking action. So with that, we will look forward to talking to you in just a moment.
We're on Facebook along with some of the greatest minds of the world, and that includes you. Visit us on Facebook at Voice America Empowerment.
Rebecca Hall Greider's Speaker Talent Search is looking for people like you. With just 1 7-minute audition, you could open the doors to hundreds of speaking opportunities. This is a dynamic way to share your message, reach more people, and expand your impact. Apply now at yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent. Finalists get to audition live in front of community leaders looking to fill all kinds of speaking opportunities. Don't wait. Find out more. Visit yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent.
Tune in to the Voice America Variety Channel on the Voice America Talk Radio Network. Voice America Variety broadcasts a diverse array of topics, reaching a global community. Our experts come from all walks of life, and the topics they discuss are everything from current events, arts and entertainment, leadership, parenting, relationships, self-improvement, career advice, and a variety of other topics. Check us out today. You're sure to find something of interest. Voice America Variety. Talk on today's hot topics.
Do you feel like sometimes you just don't know where to start with your health and fitness routine? Every week, you can hear from people who have been where you feel that you are right now and find out how they move forward and are living their best lives ever. It's called Lifestyle 360, and your host is Nicole Monier. Get inspired to take control of your health and your life. Tune into Lifestyle 360 every Tuesday at 10 a.m. Eastern Time, 7 a.m. Pacific Time on the Voice America Empowerment Channel.
Find out what makes the most successful people tick. Keep listening to the Voice America Empowerment Channel. VoiceAmericaEmpowerment.com.
You're listening to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives with your host, Rebecca Hall Greider. If you have a question or comment for Rebecca or her guest, we'd love to hear from you. Please call into the program at 1-888-346-9141. That's 1-888-346-9141. You may also send an email to Rebecca at yourpurposedrivenpractice.com. Now back to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope you enjoyed the commercial break and you got an opportunity to lean in and listen and really see what it is you are looking for and needing support in to step purposely and powerfully into 2015. And now I'm going to introduce our next guest. Grace Cloyd is an astrologer and a numerologist, which I shared with you before, with almost 25 years practicing in these specialties. She's an intuitive, founder of Life by Soul, and you have a book coming out in 2015. Is that correct?
Yes, it is coming out in 2015, finally. It looks like it'll be mid-year, so around June, July.
Perfect. And then I know you're a speaker and a workshop leader as well. So, Grace, I welcome you officially to the show.
Thank you, Rebecca. Wonderful to be here.
Happy to have you. Now, I know this work is really close to your heart and really an area that you love to support and empower people in. And sometimes there's a misunderstanding, really, about what astrology is, about numerology, about how it's different than the horoscope that you might see online or in a paper or magazine. So do you mind explaining why this work is so important to you and how it's the same or different than a horoscope? Kind of how does that all work?
Okay, well, the first thing is that everybody has all 12 signs within their makeup. So a lot of times horoscopes will focus on your sun sign. And the sun sign's important, but it's not always the most important component of your unique design.
Can I stop you for a moment? Just because I'm thinking some of our listeners may not be familiar with what a sign is.
Okay.
In this field. Do you mind explaining that?
So kind of going back to the old catchphrase, what's your sign?
Mm-hmm.
a lot of times with astrology, it's based on your sun sign. So what will happen is there's 12 signs in the Western Zodiac. So some of you may be Aries. Some of you may be Leos. Some of you may be Tauruses. So if you've ever heard one of those phrases, I'm a Taurus, I'm a Virgo, people are usually speaking in terms of their sun sign.
Perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome. And just a little bit more on that. The sun sign is usually based on your birth date.
Yes.
As is everything in an astrology chart and a numerology chart. But yeah, it's usually based on your birth date. So the sun is your core. It's your core identity. It's your grounding energy. It's what grounds and centers you. But again, it's not always the most important element in your design. And so with the horoscopes that a lot of people see in magazines or in newspapers or maybe get online or through Facebook, one of the challenges is it focuses on the sun sign, but that's not going to be the prominent energy for everybody who falls in that sun sign. So sometimes people will go, yeah, I read my horoscope. It's never really true, but And that's because it's touching on an aspect of your being, but it's not covering the entirety of your being.
Perfect. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So how does numerology and astrology, I'm sorry, does that give you a more complete picture or more in depth, or how does that work in helping someone understand more of themselves from a development perspective and leadership perspective?
Yes. So I find that the two complement each other very well. Mm-hmm. With astrology, I found that was very good for looking at certain things, but not everything. With numerology, I also found it was good at looking at certain things, but not everything. When I started putting the two together, that's when I found I was finding more of a complete picture about my clients, about, you know, the people around me, what was going on with them and within them. So the blending of the two was really important. As far as leadership goes, I find that numerology is very, well, let me go backwards here. Mm-hmm. Let me start with the astrology.
Perfect.
Yes, I find the astrology is wonderful for identifying what energy is there. And then the numerology is great at describing how that energy is used. So in the context of, let's say, Aries. Aries is the first sign of the zodiac. It often represents initiative and action. So I'm going to look at that in a chart. Sometimes there will be numerology that will apply to that. And then that will tell me how that initiative or how that action is being used.
And does this also show how it's currently being used? Does it show potential as well, or what could be tapped into? How does that connect?
Absolutely. So most people will be familiar, or, you know, people who are familiar with astrology, they will go to what is called your natal chart. So your natal chart is where everything was at the time of your birth.
Mm-hmm.
And so that is your, kind of like your cosmic blueprint. It's your unique design. So it's how you are wired. It's your hardwiring, your natal chart. And so with that natal chart, I like to look at it as a roadmap.
Mm-hmm.
And so you have all these opportunities, you have all these possibilities, and as you get to know how you are hardwired, then once you have the layout, then there is the matter of free will.
Mm-hmm.
And how you choose to step into your design. So it's one thing to have the design and to understand how you're wired and why you do what you do, but then where leadership comes into the picture is, okay, now how am I going to choose to step into this? How am I going to choose to express this out in the world?
Beautiful. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I appreciate you exploring and explaining that a little bit with me. And I didn't give you an opportunity to share why you value this work so much and bringing it to the world in the work that you do with clients and the speaking and the book that's coming out. Why is this work so important to you and pulls at your heart?
Well, for a long time, and I want to touch on one of the questions you had asked Garth earlier, which mm-hmm. is, you know, how did you come into leadership? And I used to do a lot of team activities, group activities when I was younger. And one of the things I learned along the way was, even if you're not necessarily in a leadership role by title, everybody is a leader within a group because mm-hmm. you've got to do your unique part to contribute to the greater whole. If you're,
yes.
you know, the you are the weakest link type of thing,
mm-hmm.
you can also be the strongest link. But it's when everybody in the group is maximizing their potential, when they're doing the best they can do, and when they are doing their unique part, it makes the group stronger. And
yes.
so, based on that, I realized in life, we all have leadership potential. Again, each one of us is all 12 signs. And it's just a matter of finding out what our talents are, what our abilities are, what are our goals and ambitions. Who are we? individually, and how do we share that with the world in a way where we don't only get to be our unique and individual selves, but we're also contributing to something bigger than ourselves.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. It's really, really powerful. And it's reinforcing that we all are a leader, and the part we play in life is critical, and it's important, and it affects others. So it was really, really beautiful how you shared that. And I know you've put together an amazing gift, and I'd love to give you an opportunity to share with me and our listeners what you're making available to us.
Wonderful. Well, what I'm offering today is a very simple one-page astronumerology report.
Mm-hmm.
So you would be giving me your name and your birth date, and then what I would be sending to you is a description of your base combination, which is your sun sign and your numerological life path number, mm-hmm. blended together.
Mm-hmm.
And then you would also get two other numbers. One is your projection number, and the projection number represents how you see yourself and mm-hmm. how you want others to see you. So it's the energy you're projecting out into the world. Mm-hmm. And then the second number is the number, the impression number. And that is how others see you and how they often expect or want you to show up for them.
Wow. That's really, really powerful, all in one page.
Yes, all in one page. You're welcome.
That's a really, really rich opportunity and gift. So listeners, just think about that for a moment, to really know your sun sign, which a lot of us do know, but then how it coincides with our number and how people are seeing us and expecting us to show up and the energy that we're putting out there. And if there's a gap there, that's really important and valuable to know and be aware of. So I promised I would let you know how you can access these amazing gifts. So I wanted to do that right now, so that as we're going to our commercial break, you can take advantage of that window of opportunity to lean into these gifts. So if you are interacting with this show on the Voice America site, you just want to scan over to the right-hand side of the screen, and you're going to see some yellow-orange words and links, and the first one is Radio Show Gifts. You simply click on that. You enter in your name and your email address so we can stay in touch. And a world of amazing gifts will open up, including this wonderful ebook that Garth is making available to you and this powerful one-pager that Grace is putting together for you. So I really encourage you to lean into those gifts. If you're happening to listen to the replay or are listening to this over the phone, you can also access these gifts. You'll just want to go to my website, which is www.yourpurposedrivenpractice.com. Hit the radio show tab, and up in the left-hand corner, you're going to see empowering free gifts. And you want to click on that link. Again, put your name and email address in so we stay in touch, and you'll have the same opportunity for those powerful gifts to really support you in living your life on purpose and with purpose. So I encourage everyone to take a deep breath, roll your shoulders back, and we're going to go to our commercial break. And I really encourage you to take that focused action to really empower you on your journey. And we'll look forward to talking to you in just a moment.
Live up to your fullest potential. This is the Voice America Empowerment Channel.
Now you can take your favorite Voice America radio program with you anywhere. Sign up for our mobile app if you have an iPhone, Android, or BlackBerry. The Voice America Interactive Radio Player, powered by Aircast, gives you the freedom to listen to any of our programs anywhere, live, and on demand. No registration is required. Listen to your favorite Voice America hosts and discover new ones. Download the Voice America mobile app for iPhone, Android, or BlackBerry, powered by Aircast. Visit the Apple iTunes App Store, BlackBerry App World, or Android Market.
Rebecca Hall Greider's Speaker Talent Search is looking for people like you. With just one 7-minute audition, you could open the doors to hundreds of speaking opportunities. This is a dynamic way to share your message, reach more people, and expand your impact. Apply now at yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent. Finalists get to audition live in front of community leaders looking to fill all kinds of speaking opportunities. Don't wait. Find out more. Visit yourpurposedrivenpractice.net/speaker-talent.
Success starts here. VoiceAmericaEmpowerment.com. It's your world.
You're listening to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives with your host, Rebecca Hall Greider. If you have a question or comment for Rebecca or her guest, we'd love to hear from you. Please call into the program at 1-888-346-9141. That's 1-888-346-9141. You may also send an email to Rebecca at yourpurposedrivenpractice.com. Now back to Empowering Women, Transforming Lives.
Welcome back, everyone. I hope you enjoyed our commercial break and that you actually had an opportunity to check out those amazing gifts to really empower you to move forward powerfully as we finish up December and we move into the new year, to really stand in a leadership position. And some of the messages that we've been talking about and keep coming up throughout the show, I just wanted to reinforce again how the concept that everyone is a leader, really looking at taking focused action, putting things into movement, information and wisdom that we've gained through our life, really applying that and moving forward. And then I like the phrase that you use, Grace, about one plate at a time, one step at a time. We can't do it all at once, but we can take consistent steps forward to move closer to where we're wanting to be in our life and where we're wanting to stand in a leadership position. And I asked both of my guests kind of behind the scene if they had one more tip or one more piece of wisdom that what they wanted to share with us today and really empower us with. And so with that, I would love to invite you, Garth, to share your tip to help take it to the next level for us.
To keep us on track, frequently we need an accountability partner. Mm-hmm. So what I'd recommend is when people take the or read the ebook, they share it with someone else, and then about June 1st, they get together and say, so how are you doing on it? Because we all know the new year happens, and by the end of January, all those resolutions have gone. So aim forward to June 1st, and with your accountability partner, see how well you're doing for 2015.
Beautiful. I love that because it also lets us do a check-in and make a shift before the end of the year if we're getting a little off course or we've fallen behind or we need to reevaluate something. So I think that's a beautiful, beautiful suggestion. Thank you, Garth.
You're welcome.
And then Grace, I know you had something that you put together from an astrologist perspective about leadership. Do you mind sharing?
Oh, certainly. So, well, as an astrologer, numerologist, you know, I see a lot of people hardwiring. And one of the things I've found is when people come to have a chart done, they're usually coming either because they're really feeling lost and they don't really have a sense of themselves, or they have a sense of themselves, they're just looking for affirmation. They're looking for that little boost or that push to step into who they are. So three little things I wanted to share are three points of leadership. And I also see leadership as ownership. Mm-hmm. Because when you're stepping into a leadership role or stepping into being a leader in your life, you really are saying, I'm going to, you know, own my life. I'm taking ownership for it. I'm taking responsibility for it. So number one is own your identity. Own who you are. Just say, you know what, this is who I am. This is how I'm wired. This is how I do what I do, and I'm ready to embrace all of that. Number two is own your talents and your abilities. Don't be shy about what you can do. It's really important because that's what you have to offer the world. That's what you have to offer to other people. And it doesn't have to be huge. It doesn't have to be, you know, on a stage and floodlights or anything. It's owning what you have to contribute to others. And then number three is own your goals and your ambitions. And they may not be tied in with your talents and abilities. Sometimes those talents and abilities give you the opportunity to fulfill your other goals and ambitions. But right. Own those goals, own those ambitions, dream big and say yes to yourself.
Beautiful. Thank you. I love
You're
that.
Welcome.
And listeners, I want you to pause for just a moment and think about this information that we're sharing with you. Really, how can you step into that leadership position? I love the concept of ownership with that, really owning who you are and bringing yourself forward in such a way that you're sharing your gifts and your talents and your abilities. And I believe this is so, so important because no one else is made like you. Nobody else is your unique mixture of abilities and talents and experience and vision. And if you're not willing to bring that forward and share it with those around you, we all miss out. The world's a little less rich, a little less bright. You're the only one of you that we have. There's not a backup somewhere behind a curtain that if you don't share more of yourself or you shy away or it's intimidating, that's going to step up and do take two. This is the opportunity we have to richly embrace you in our lives. And I really want you to be all that you're created to be. I want you to step fully into your path of projection, to really step into being a leader in your life and really living in a purposeful way. You are a huge and valuable gift. And that's why I really want to provide you with valuable insight, tips, experts, and support so that you can be equipped and empowered to fully stand in your life and bring the great gift that you are to each and every one of us. And here's what I would personally love from each of you. I would love for you to take a moment today, this week, and to pause and maybe find three things and write them down that you're wanting to step forward in just a little bit more. And if you need the support, you need accountability, whatever it is, you need encouragement, whatever it is that you need to step more powerfully into those things, write it down and be willing to get that support, to get that help, to celebrate. Maybe it's celebrating and acknowledging whatever it is. You are valuable, important, and needed. And I would love to receive a note or a message from you saying, Rebecca, I said yes. You don't have to share with me all the details. Of course, I love knowing anything I can encourage you in. But I would love to energetically support you in your yes, that you're saying yes to you, you're saying yes to yourself, yes to stretching and stepping forward in a more powerful way, bringing more of you forward as a gift to all of us. As we're ending 2014, stepping into 2015, I would love to support you in your yes and really bringing the gift of you forward in a powerful way. Take a moment, a deep breath. And just see, are you a yes? Are you willing to share just a little bit more of you with all of us? Are you willing to step a little bit more into that ownership and leadership position in your life? Just listen to your inner wisdom, to your heart, to your mind. Are you a yes? And then if you are, lean into at least one of those three. I'd love it if it were all three areas or action items that you can step forward in and declare that you're saying yes. Know that we are lifting you up, supporting you in your journey. We are here to help, empower, and equip you as you're stepping forward, living your life on purpose and with purpose. And may you always, always, always bloom where you're planted and shine. We look forward to talking to you next week.
Thank you for joining us this week for Empowering Women, Transforming Lives.
Please tune in again for another edition with your host, Rebecca Hall Greider, next Wednesday at 5 p.m. Eastern Time and 2 p.m. Pacific Time on the Voice America Empowerment Channel. Have a beautiful week, and may you always bloom where you're planted and shine.